And we are about to wrap up the first round of the Glory First 16, the final fight of the opening round, Fabio Pinca of France against one of the tournament favorites from Italia, Giorgio Petrosian. And don't forget, the super fights are coming up, three of them culminating with the vacant Glory Heavyweight Championship on the line when Sammy Schilt squares off with Errol Zimmerman. And I concur with you, Stephen. If that was Albert Krauss in slow motion, man, we'd have to watch the next fight in slow motion. Here comes Fabio Pinca from France, a 2010 Thai fight champion, a WMC world champion in the past, another man with Muay Thai background, but this is under Glory Federation rules. This is the best in stand-up fighting. 16 of the top fighters on the planet in the 154-pounder, 70-kilogram weight class, Fabio Pinca, also a name to remember and look out for. This guy has quite an impressive resume.
He really does. Well-known in Thailand, where he fights quite often. And of course, he's looking for revenge here tonight against Petrosian because he lost the last time they fought 8 years ago in 2004.
And that was just Pinca's fourth professional fight. That was under full Muay Thai rules as well.
Stepping in from the red corner, Giorgio Petrosian.
Sees everything you ever wanted. One moment to capture. Just let it slip. Yo. His palms are sweaty. Knees, feet, arms are heavy.
Armenian, Italian, two-time K-1 World Max Champion in 2009 and 2010. A man who started to train Muay Thai at the age of 14 when he moved to Italy from Armenia. He had his first professional bout at the age of 16, and now, at the age of 26, he wants to serve notice in this tournament that he is indeed the very best and the man to beat.
Really? Giorgio Petrosian, one of the most gifted kickboxing athletes to ever fight in the ring. Super fast, super accurate, super technical, and very unpredictable. This guy, like, has radar. When he sees punches and kicks coming, he just not there, and then all of a sudden you get hit or kicked.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, he is 27 years of age, weighing in at 68.7 kilograms. He stands 175 centimeters with a fighting record of 110 fights, 88 wins and 19 losses. His titles includes 2010 Thai Fight Champion, 2008 WMC World Champion, fighting out of Lyon, France, representing Team Nasser Kacem, Fabio Pinca! Fighting out of the red corner, he is 26 years of age, weighing in at 69.9 kilograms. He stands 178 centimeters. He has a fighting record of 38 fights, 36 wins, one loss, and one draw. His titles include the 2009 and 2010 K-1 Max World Champion. Fighting out of Armenia through Italy, representing Satori Gladiatoro Nemesis Gym, Giorgio the
So after this fight, we will either be saying Viva la France or Forza Azzurri as France's Fabio Pinca meets Italy's Giorgio Petrosian in the final bout of the opening round of the Glory First 16. What a way to wrap things up with Giorgio Petrosian and Fabio Pinca having met, as you mentioned, Stephen, early in Pinca's career, just his fourth professional fight under full Muay Thai rules. He lost to Petrosian, looking to gain revenge, and this, without a doubt, the biggest fight of his career. And the bell, round one underway, Petrosian out of the red corner, Pinca out of the blue.
What a way to round out the tournament with this fight. Such a competitive match on paper. But look what we got here, that straight left hand by Petrosian. Early warning for Pinka, that straight left from the southpaw. Surgical, known as the doctor, always executing techniques with surgical precision, as we just saw.
It's as if he knows what you're going to do. And that can be an unsettling feeling.
And then challenging you to try to stop it. Left body kick, liver kick there, and straight left. Pinka misses with a counter left.
Pinka not using a setup on either one of those two missed roundhouse kicks.
Pinka, known as one of the best non-Thai fighters on the international Muay Thai scene, but again, this is under glory rules. No elbows allowed. Clinch fighting very minimal, as we have seen. We were told they'd allow 3 seconds. That hasn't exactly been the case, but nevertheless, push kick from Petrosian. Counter kick to the body by Pinka, doubles up. Straight left, the blood go by Pinka. Petrosian throwing everything with bad intentions, even though it may not seem like that. Just very effective in his attacks.
He's so relaxed.
Very makes it look easy.
Yeah, exactly. It's very intuitive the way he fights. But it's so intuitive, it's like hyper-intuitive. I'm telling you, man, that straight left hand from Petrosian, that's going to be a problem if it lands.
Effective counter striking as well on display from the doctor here in the first round. That kick was blocked. Body kick delivered by Pinka. Final 60 seconds of the opening round. And this is the final matchup of the Glory First 16 tournament. One of these athletes will join 7 others in the final 8 coming up later this year, where the winner will emerge with a $300,000 grand prize. And already some witness under the right arm of Petrosian. Those kicks taking their toll from Pinka.
That's the problem. When you catch those kicks on the arm, that can hurt. And eventually, it's going to be hard to keep those hands up or throw a punch.
Final 30 seconds of the opening frame.
But the counterpunching of Petrosian has been what this first round has been all about. Petrosian is going to coast this one out.
Pinka catching nice the catch and sweep. Nice counter there by Pinka as round 2 is straight ahead here in Stockholm, Sweden.
Great first round on a technical sense by both men, landed great kicks, but it was Petrosian's punching that got through more often. I give him that round 10-9. A lot of leg catches there, but Petrosian came out early, tried to barnstorm Pinka. It's a certain technique where you set up the kick off the punch, but that was a great sweep by Pinka. Pinka's here to win it. Intense look in his eyes. He fought strong, but in my opinion, he lost that first round.
Bell and the second round. The 3 judges here in Sweden concurring with the fight professor, Stephen Quadros. Clean sweep in that opening round for the Dr. Giorgio Petrosian, coming off a win over another great veteran in Artur Kashenko, beating him in Milano, Italy in March of this year. Counterattack again on display here as Pinka comes forward, but a lot of those strikes are blocked by Petrosian, who again manages to effectively counterstrike.
And in that clinch, Petrosian did a really interesting thing. He's not in a mixed martial arts fight, but he stepped his foot in where he could have gotten a trip there.
Now Pinka attacking the lead leg. Those kicks were checked, and good head movement on display now from the doctor. Max Pinka into the ropes momentarily, clinch.
You can't get a higher level kickboxing match than this.
This is the peak of the sport.
We have seen so much great action so far here with the Glory for 16. Mauro Ranallo and the Fight Professor, Stephen Quadros, so happy not only to be working together once again, Stephen, but really being the best seats in the house for what has been a great start to this tournament. Great crowd here in Stockholm, Sweden at the Annex, and we hope you're enjoying it wherever you may be watching around the world on GloryWorldSeries.com. Hope you're following us at Glory_WS.
On Twitter.
Ooh, nice left hook from Petrosian. They come to close quarters and break before the referee can step in.
It was nice to see some knee fighting in there, too.
Yep, midway through the round and the fight, the final first round battle here. And left away, Petrosian just steps back, allows Pinka to hit nothing but air and comes back with a counter left, but Pinka catches the kick again, and he's done that a couple of times.
Need to get a warning for that.
Yeah, and unfortunately, that's the makeup of this tournament. Coming from that Muay Thai background, you have to play by the Glory Federation rules in this tournament.
Pinka really targeting that left arm with a roundhouse kick, hoping that he can slow down that straight left hand, but it hasn't worked so far.
And Pinka's anatomy beginning to look a little pink as he's taking shots all over the place here from Giorgio Petrosian. Straight left through the guard. Low kick on the outside. There's a push kick from Pinka.
Good, I'm glad we got clinch fighting. Love the knee, love the wrestling.
A referee coming on, one of the best. And his craft here in Stockholm, Sweden. Crowd enjoying all of the action. Good combination, culminating with a two from Petrosian. There's a knee right to the belly. 20 seconds left of the round.
The problem with the side knee, though, is it's a point scorer. It's not a knockout vehicle. And you really got to worry about trying to hurt Giorgio Petrosian, which nobody's really been able to do.
Third round coming up.
Giorgio Petrosian continues to out-technique the great Fabio Pinka, and he did it with punches. Pinka coming in with kicks, and Petrosian answering back always with at least a 1-2, possibly a 1-2-3. There's a counter. He slid back and threw that straight left hand. There's a knee by Petrosian, but Pinka landed more knees in that round, but that wasn't enough to take the round, in my opinion. Petrosian with a fade back there, coming back with his straight left hand a couple times. Second one missed.
Terrific technique on display.
And just elusive as hell.
Very elusive.
Seconds out. Third and final round.
Two athletes touch gloves as the third and final round is underway. The official scorecards also giving Petrosian both rounds thus far. His lone loss coming at the venerable Lumpini Stadium in Bangkok, Thailand, when he went five rounds with Nonthanan Porpremic back in 2007. Otherwise, it has been nothing but smooth sailing in the combat sports career of Giorgio the Dr. Petrosian.
I think they're getting warned. He's getting looked at, too.
Cut over his left eye. Pinka saying it was from a clash of heads. I think they're trying to convince the referee that it was from a headbutt. Momentary lapse here is still to come. Three super fights from the Annex in Stockholm, Sweden. This is the final matchup of what has been a sensational start to the Glory First 16 tournament, the best stand-up tournament in recent memory on display here in Pinka now, maybe knowing that, hey, if they stopped it already to check the cut, I better fight like my very life depends on it.
But they're so blasting. The technical battle style is not going to work here. He's got to turn this into an alley fight.
Let's give the doctor some of his own medicine, but you're right, he has to make it ugly, I think, right now if he wants to pull out the victory.
Oh, you can hear the slap on that one.
Oh, good straight left. That stopped Pink in his tracks.
Very crisp combinations being executed by the southpaw Petrosian. Pink the coming forward.
If you want to learn how to throw a 1-2, watch Giorgio Petrosian. And it's a right left in his face.
Does Petrosian need to make some sort of a statement knowing that a lot of people feel he is the favorite? Or, I mean, it's obvious that he's done very well in this fight, Stephen, but is there a message that needs to be sent, or is this the kind of fight you'd like from him in the opening round?
Well, there's like, and then there's continued being unbeaten, which he has been since that one fight in Thailand.
Pinka now, though, beginning to get busy upstairs.
I think it's one of those, if it ain't broke, don't fix it scenarios where Petrosian needs to get the win and needs to outclass his opponents. Having excitement and fighting with wild abandon like some of the lower level stand-up fighters can do, it's exciting for the crowd, but it's not going to make you a legend.
Well said, is Petrosian still in there with a very gutsy and valiant effort from Fabio Pinka, but Pinka needs to pull out all the stops here in the final 35 seconds of the fight. Petrosian with a liver kick, and again, that elusiveness on display. Counter left hand from the southpaw Petrosian.
Pinka did land a couple of good right hooks there, but it wasn't enough.
Pinka then comes back. Now Petrosian, there's a couple of left hooks again from Pinka. Left hand from Petrosian, 15 seconds left in the fight.
Cosmetic damage is not how you judge a fight, but here, it's a show of exactly what Petrosian has done.
We're off to the judges' scorecards. The opening round of the Glory First 16 has ended in Sweden.
It wasn't a wild fight, but you know, I was completely compelled by this fight because you've got two guys that technically are very high level. But what we saw was the absolute elusive counter-punching and kicking and kneeing by Giorgio Petrosian, which I have winning the fight, the 30-27. Here, Pinka needs to get rough. He knows it. He's got to come in there blasting away. But Petrosian, if you walk into something, it's going to be your fault. And Petrosian is there to throw that something at you. Petrosian eating a couple shots here. And there was a spinning back fist, but it didn't land. Pinka gave it his all. But I think he came up short here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for both fighters. Italy versus France in the house. We have a unanimous decision. 3-0 and advancing to the final eight. In the quest for $300,000, the winner, Red Corner, Giorgio the Doctor Petrosian!
Il Dottore Giorgio Petrosian, congratulations on a very impressive win. We've got the translator here as well. First of all, Giorgio, they call him the doctor, and he was putting that surgical precision on display. How happy was he with his performance tonight?
Stato molto, molto chirurgico questa sera, più che mai. Sei contento della tua prestazione?
Ma contento solo per la vittoria, ma sono tante cose che devo lavorare così per migliorare meglio.
I'm really happy for the victory, but there are still a lot of things that I have to work out to get it perfect.
Can you share with us some of those things?
Fai la lista. Cosa devi lavorare ancora?
Beh, questo mi dirà il mio maestro.
His coach will say that, and not to you.
Tante grazie, Giorgio Petrosian, the winner here tonight. Let's hear it for all of the 16 fighters who competed in the Glory First 16. What a great start to the tournament, Sweden.
Petrosian not real eager to get out those trade secrets here to his competition.